Hi friends, it's Tess, this is Wander Wealthy, and today I'm going to share with you my 11 tips for surviving holiday travel, specifically air travel, specifically in the airport. If you're new to my channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button plus the little bell so you can be notified when I upload more videos and new videos on a weekly basis all about personal growth, personal finance, and travel. All right, so the holidays are in full swing. That means a lot of people are traveling home for the holidays or away for the holidays, and the airports are going to be insane. So I wanted to compile a holiday travel survival guide for you. Most of these are tips on how to get through the airport, because I find the most stressful part of traveling over the holidays is getting into the airport and getting through the airport and then onto the airplane. When you're at home, you're fine. When you're on the airplane, you're fine. But everything in between can be a little bit stressful. So here are my tips for you. Number one is to check in online. I have pretty much every travel app that I could have on my phone. This isn't everyone I could have. All of the airlines that I typically fly on, I have on my phone so that I can go to the app and I can check in online. I can pick my seat. If connections are going to be really hard to make or something, I try to pick a seat towards the front of the plane so I can get off and get to the next airplane in the nick of time. But having these things on your phone or being able to check in online will allow you to just be able to take care of all of that so you don't have to take care of it at the airport, as long as you don't have to check a bag, of course. But you can also, usually if you're flying Southwest, get a better rank, however that works, and boarding position. If you're flying a different airline, then you can typically get a better seat if you check in earlier. Tip number two is for the packing, and I'm already doing a video about how to pack for the holidays, but this is very specific and very important. If you are bringing gifts or if you're trying to get gifts from your current home to the place that you're going, then consider mailing them ahead of time or just directly shipping them to that address and then calling my mom, like I always do, and saying, "Mom, don't open that thing that you're gonna get in the mail from me. It has my name on it, but it has your address, and don't open it. It's your gift." That's a smart thing to do, because then you don't have to worry about packing it so that you can pack the rest of your stuff. Plus, if you do try to carry on certain gifts and they might be liquid, they are over the limit or whatever, then it's gonna cause some trouble for you. So just consider mailing them or shipping them there ahead of time. Tip number three, and this kind of is a packing tip as well, but it's to check the weather ahead of time. You want to know this not only for the clothes that you're going to pack, but also for the status of your flight. So if you know the weather, then you can kind of have an idea of how things are going to roll at the airport that you're about to go to. Which leads me to tip number four, which is to go to the airport early. And I mean really early, like 3 hours early. You typically don't have to do this for normal air travel, but during the holidays, everyone is trying to get out of Dodge. So you have to prepare for that. Plus, it's the winter, unless you live in New Zealand or Australia. So you're going to typically have the risk of high winds, snow, sleet, rain, ice, all of the above. Things are going to be a little bit chaotic, so you just want to prepare and get there early. With that, you might have to expect delays. So although you're trying to get to the airport early to be able to manage the crowds, you're also going to have to expect the fact that you might be sitting in the airport for a few hours until your flight takes off, and thus you're going to need to entertain yourself. So bring something like a book or your computer with pre-downloaded shows on it or movies, or I love to listen to podcasts on my phone. Whatever it is, it's going to pass the time for you because you're gonna need it. In addition to that, you'll wanna make sure you are stocked up on your battery, but also bring chargers for your electronics. However, airports tend to be the most frustrating places in the world and have very limited plugins for your electronics, so just make sure your batteries are charged. That's gonna save your life a ton. With that being said, that leads me to tip number 6, which is to consider splurging on airline lounges. If you're getting to the airport super early and then you have delays, you could consider spending anywhere from $20 to $70 and get yourself inside an airline lounge. There they have free Wi-Fi, really awesome bathrooms, usually free food, and easily accessible outlets so you can plug in your electronics. Depending on how long you're going to be waiting or staying in the airport, it's just something to consider. Tip number 7 is to be patient. There are a lot of first-time travelers going through the airport during the holiday season, so be patient with the fact that lines are going to move slow, people are going to be a little bit confused and not know exactly what they're doing, and you might need to take a little bit of a chill pill. Or download an awesome meditation app on your phone and meditate so that you can zen out for yourself. I would also consider getting some noise-canceling headphones if you can't stand the ruckus around you, because again, lots of people, lots of first-time travelers, lots of people not knowing what they're doing, lots of delays, lots of people upset. It's just going to drive you a little bit insane. Tip number 8, if something happens, your flight gets super delayed, which makes you miss a connection, or your flight gets canceled altogether, then instead of waiting in the customer service line at the airport and feeling like you're dying slowly, while you're waiting there, consider calling the customer service phone number on your phone to see which one you can get through faster. This is a little game I like to play called Who's Getting There First, and I always want it to be me. So when I'm delayed, I will stand in the line as it inches slowly into the dark ages. I will call the number on my phone. I'll also, another hack is to use social media and tweet at them or send them a direct message. Figure out any way you can maneuver your way into getting help as fast as possible. This is just a simple trick to skip the lines that you will be facing. Tip number 9 is to bring extra snacks with you, because airplane food is expensive, so is airport food, and if you're on a budget, you might as well bring your own because you can. Just remember that liquids are limited when you try to walk through the airport. Tip number 10 is to have a backup plan. Unfortunately, like I said, winter weather, lots of people, other things happening, people acting out over holiday joy or anger or fear can lead to some pretty annoying and stressful situations where things happen. So if your flight is canceled or extremely delayed that it's going to not even be worth it, or you just miss your flight and you feel like you are screwed, then consider having a backup plan. What's it going to be? For me, I don't live that far away from home, so I can always drive if I have to, although it sucks, but I can't. For other people, it might be figuring out how to get to a different airport in a different city. There are many, many different options. There's trains, there's Ubers. You could pay a lot of money for someone to drive you across the country if you really needed it. Or you could just consider staying home and spending the holidays alone, which is sad, but you know, might be the case. I'm sorry. Have a backup plan. Just know what your plan B is so that when shit hits the fan, you can figure out what you're gonna do next without calling your dad crying, because I've done that before. And tip number 11 is to communicate with the home front. Your loved ones, your friends, your family, whoever it is that you are going to see will probably want to know what's going on. So give them a jingle and let them know what is happening. Especially if they have to drive a long ways to come pick you up from the airport, they might not be checking the status of your flight, so you might need to tell them what's going on. It's a good idea. And those are my 11 survival tips for holiday travel. I hope that it helps you as you get to the place you want to go during this holiday season, or even next year, because you can never plan too early. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you hit the subscribe button so you can be notified when I upload new videos, which I do on a weekly basis. And I'd love to hear your tips. Comment below, let me know, and have a wonderful holiday season. To get more amazing content from me, to get more great content from me exclusive to you and the women that are in my group, join the Wealthy Wanderers private Facebook community. Go to wanderwealthy.com/FB to get your invite, and I will see you in there. Until then, I hope you wander wealthy, especially this time of year. Okay, I'm gonna stop leaving now.